With all the different grafting techniques that can be used, choosing the right one for each job can be a challenge. Several factors might determine the best techniques to use, the first being the fruit species. We can't really say that grafting techniques are fruit species dependent. Nevertheless, some grafting techniques will have a greater success rate on some fruit species than others. Time of year is one of the most important limiting factors when deciding which grafting technique to use. With some techniques, the plants can be dormant, while with others the sap must be flowing, so the bark lifts freely, like when T-budding. So, the season and the time of year will also limit the range of techniques that can be used. Rootstocks and available cyans can have different diameters, so you might have to choose a different technique depending on what you have to work with. All these limiting factors will determine the best grafting techniques to choose when grafting our fruit trees in the home orchard. Another common grafting situation will result from the need to change the variety on an established tree. The tree might already have a few years, and one of the best techniques to do the job is bark grafting. With this technique, you can completely remove the old variety and benefit from the established root system. This technique can be used with almost any type of fruit tree with good results. The best time of the year to do it is when the tree is leaving dormancy, usually early spring in most areas. The new variety will grow quickly and will usually start producing fruits in 2 or 3 years due to the stronger rootstock. It's usually best to leave only one of the grafts. Two branches that grow from the same point will compete with each other and the tree will be more difficult to shape correctly. With compatible species, you can not only change the fruit variety, but also the fruit type. Here, an almond tree was grafted with a couple of peach varieties. With older and bigger trees, you can even graft several varieties in different branches, producing a multi-variety fruit tree. This technique allows the use of normal sized cyans, and several can be placed around a large diameter branch. The connection between cambium layers is quite easy, unlike other techniques, as the cambium is right between the bark and the trunk. Leaving a branch from the original tree is important to allow sap flow while the grafts are developing. Supporting the new branches is also a good idea to avoid wind breakage. The following year, the new grafts will need pruning, and some might need to be removed, choosing the best placed ones. The same bark grafting technique can be used when changing varieties in younger trees. As a norm, don't leave the two grafts, as one might develop stronger and the resulting tree will be unbalanced. Nevertheless, when grafting two different varieties to the same rootstock, you can try it though, as it may work in some cases. But when you want to graft several varieties to the same tree, it may be best to leave some of the main branches and graft them instead. If you want to graft 1-year-old branches, the bark grafting technique won't work in these smaller diameter branches, so whip and tongue or cleft graft are the best option. When using the whip and tongue technique, the diameter of the scion and the rootstock should be almost identical. If there is a difference in diameter, matching the cambium layers might be difficult, a non-existent problem when using the bark grafting technique. The cambium, in this type of cut, is a very thin layer that may be impossible to match with different diameter branches. If this happens in your grafting situation, pull the scion to one side, or better yet, skew it so the cambium layers cross at some point. Although not being one of the easiest techniques, whip and tongue is one of the best, if you consider the percentage of success in a wide range of different fruit trees. It has lots of cambium contact points and produces a firm and solid graft. It's best used in early spring, just before the trees leave dormancy, but it's also effective in warmer months and in the fall. Adjust the graft firmly using tape, a rubber strip, or natural raffia. When using raffia or a strip of rubber, it's necessary to protect the graft union with parafilm. This avoids graft failure from rainwater or dehydration. Whip and tongue will work with most fruit types, including evergreen trees like this loquat. When grafting in warmer periods, don't forget to cover the graft with aluminium foil to protect it from direct sun. In some areas, parafilm might not biodegrade quickly enough. Be sure to remove it after the graft takes, or the moisture might accumulate inside and damage the graft. When trying to graft branches of different diameters, I always use the modified cleft graft. This grafting technique has a much higher success rate than the normal cleft, and it produces a much cleaner graft union. Making the cut near the edge of the rootstock, it's much easier to achieve a good cambium contact, particularly near the base of the scion. A shorter scion with only two buds works perfectly. Covering the graft and the scion with parafilm will produce very high percentages of successful grafts. If you want to know more about the modified cleft graft and whip and tongue techniques, follow the links in the video description. When grafting young rootstocks, the cleft graft is still one of the easiest techniques to use for the beginner. When using this grafting technique, be sure to use rootstocks and scions of the same diameter. The rootstock and the scions should both be in dormancy. Grafting indoors and leaving the plants in a greenhouse will allow for a quicker developing graft when spring arrives. If you only have available cyanes that are very thin, use the lateral graft technique instead. This type of graft will allow the use of extremely narrow cyanes. This would be useless with any other technique. Beware that this technique will produce an extremely narrow angle with the rootstock. So, the upper part of the branch is cut as soon as the graft takes to avoid it. Lateral grafts can also be used to change varieties. This is a lateral graft executed in a branch of a young almond tree in early March. In the summer, the graft is fully developed. A second graft, unsupported, broke with strong winds. The same graft 1 year later. The same grafting technique used in a loquat tree. Don't forget to keep removing growing buds from the old variety, or these will compete with the new graft. Finally, you can also use bud grafting techniques, like sheep budding or tip budding. This can be used in the spring, in the fall, and in the other seasons, as long as the sap is flowing. These techniques work with almost all fruit types, and they are the best when grafting material is scarce, as they only use one bud per graft. In the channel, I have several videos with lots of information and detail about bud grafting. Be sure to check them out if you want to know more. Thanks for watching. Like, subscribe and share the video to support the channel. If you like the video or if you have any questions, leave a comment and I will try to reply. Click the bell to receive notifications of new videos.